This video is brought to you by Squarespace. In today's video, we're gonna see how we can create the screen pump effect in Final Cut Pro 10 without any plugins required. We are in the Final Cut Pro 10 interface and we will see how we can create the screen pump effect very easily. So, basically, let's play and see. We have 1, 2, and 3, 3 beats. Basically, there are 5, but the main beat is the third one. We will go where the first beat drops, let's say here, and we will press M in our keyboard to add a marker. We will select the clip and then we will go into the inspector panel and we will change the scale to 120%. After that, we will add a keyframe and we will go again into our timeline. We will go 1-2 frames to the left and we will change the scale all into 100. Again, we will go into our marker and go this time 2 frames to the right using the arrow in our keyboard. And we will change again the scale to all to 100. So we have the first screen pump. Okay, now if we select the clip and we right click it and click on show video animation, we will see that we have these keyframes here. Let me zoom in a little bit. Perfect. And if we press Shift in our keyboard and click on the other two, we can change where the effect takes place into our timeline. Now we will press Option Shift and C to copy the keyframes of the animation of the transform. And we will go where the next bit drops. And we will press the Option or Alt, Shift, and V. Then again, I'm selecting the first keyframe and by holding Shift, the other two. And I will place it here where I want on the second bit, as you can see here in the waveform, to happen. And again, let me zoom out a little bit, and we have 2-2. Okay. Again, Option, Shift, and C. I'm copying them. Going here and Option Shift and V to paste them. Now I want to adjust it to bring it a little bit to the right, so I'm selecting them again and I'm placing to the right. So as you can see here, perfect. If you want, you can make more of that, like to go 2 times, and also we can mess a little bit more to add some more effects into that if it's in your taste, like I did in the video that you saw in the beginning of this tutorial. Let's take a moment now and talk about the sponsor of this episode, Squarespace. If you're a YouTuber, photographer, videographer, creative artist in general, or a freelancer, the mandatory thing, the thing that you need the most is a website. And if you don't have any knowledge at all at web design, web developing, then Squarespace is here to help you. With Squarespace, you can choose between plenty of designers' high-end templates to use them as a structure and start building your own website without having, I'm saying it again, any knowledge at all at web design. So if you don't have a website and you want to have one, head over to squarespace.com/Emilio. You can try it first, and then when you're ready to buy, use the coupon code Emilio to get 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain. Also, by using the coupon code Emilio, you support my channel. Let's go now back into the tutorial. So I will go into the effects panel and I will type focus. I will drag the focus and place it here. And now that I have already my keyframes in the video animation, I'm gonna go here. I'm gonna set the amount to 40%, the emphasis to 100, and I will add a keyframe on the amount. I will go to the other keyframe here. I will change the amount to 0 here in the inspector panel, and then go here and change the amount to 0 again. Again, the same process. I'm selecting all the keyframes, Option Shift and copy, and Option Shift and V, and again selecting here Option Shift and V. V or V, anyway. And let's place a little bit of handheld as a second effect. Again, the same process. We go where the keyframe of the marker is. We will make the shakiness to 100%. It doesn't even matter because it's going to be very quick. And we're adding keyframes. Again, shakiness to 0. For distance, we can leave it where I have it. As you can see, this is more of a situation where you want the handle to stay in place and you have an actual video and not just a simple effect that you're going to use for just a second or 4 frames. And again, I'm selecting the keyframes, Option Shift and copy, Option Shift and V, and Option Shift and V. Remember that you need to have selected the effect that you want the keyframes to copy and paste. And let's play. Perfect. We can go really crazy about it. We can add a prism effect or whatever effect that you want. So let's say we have a prism effect as well. We go here, we set the amount all the way to the right and add a keyframe. Go to the next frame on the right, amount 0, and to the first frame on the left, amount 0. We're selecting the keyframes, Option Shift copy. And again, the same process, we select the keyframes and we copy and paste them. Also, you can copy and paste the keyframes by going into the edit, keyframes, copy and paste. And let's go and see the final result. I hope you found this video helpful, and if you did, don't forget to hit the like button as it helps a lot to the video for ranking and to the channel. If you have any questions about this tutorial, I'm waiting for them in the comment section down below. Thank you so much for watching. I'm Emilio Takas, and I will see you in the next video.